have to ask first what your take is on what's happening in the market right now. What is your outlook?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, first of all, it's great to be here in person with you. And by the way, congratulations on this very special show. So we're excited to be here. Look, you know, when I look at the market, I would say a couple things. You know, the semiconductor market has been so strong over the last several years, and we've certainly been trying to ramp up production across the board. When you look at today's market, you know, there are certain portions of the market that are actually doing extremely well. Things like you know, our data center business, our embedded business that services aerospace and defense, industrial, automotive, you know, these parts of the businesses. And then there are some parts of the businesses that are, you know, going through a little bit of a lower demand period, and those are like, you know, PCs and you know, consumer devices. And so we're navigating through that. But, you know, again, it's a very exciting day for us because we just launched our new server chips. So I'm so glad that we could talk to you a little bit about that.
So let's talk about the new chip. How do you hope this one will change the game?
Well, I have to say, you know, our server roadmap has been like a five-year journey. So we launched the first EPYC server line in 2017. And over the last 5 years, we've had three generations of truly leadership performance. So with our new generation, fourth generation EPYC, and we codename it Genoa, it's really game changing for the server market. You know, when I talk about things like, you know, significantly higher performance, significantly better overall energy efficiency, significantly lower operating costs, you know, depending on, you know, which environment that you're in. And we're talking about, you know, 2.5 to 3 times the competition. So we're extremely excited with it.
You've gotten a lead now over Intel. How sustainable is that lead? Because Pat Gelsinger has said, we're going to be in the lead again. And what if this is just a moment in the sun for you?
Well, what I can say is I think hopefully the last 5 years has been proof. You know, our goal has been to every year have a stronger and stronger roadmap to broaden how we work with our partners and customers. You know, if you look across the world at cloud data centers, you know, AMD is now the standard for cloud data centers. And it's really because of our, you know, performance and our overall efficiency and our total cost of ownership. So, you know, we are not taking our foot off the gas pedal. We're going to continue to innovate very strongly.
So let's talk about, look, if we are going into a prolonged recession, how is your strategy evolving? Are you trying to cut costs? Are you going to do layoffs?
Well, it's a very interesting point, Emily. You know, I think a couple things. We've been working on really diversifying our business. So it's not just about, you know, one product line. We actually have a broad product, a set of product lines. As I said, data center and embedded actually quite strong, and we're gaining share. And then on the PC market and consumer, it's a little bit lower, and we're navigating through that. And, you know, our roadmaps take 3 to 5 years to develop. So we are not at all backing off of our roadmap. You know, we're going to navigate through this. We're going to be tighter on, you know, overall operating expenses, but we're also going to invest in R&D so that we can keep increasing our lead.
What about rising tension between the U.S. and China? How does that change the game for you, just as the chip crisis was starting to ease?
Well, we're always, you know, very, you know, watching the situation as it relates to the geopolitics. I would say, you know, China is an important market, but we're also very cognizant of the U.S., you know, restrictions, and we're operating within those. And I would say that we've, you know, again, navigating through, you know, these things.
How low can PCs go, though? I think there's this question, was this just a pandemic blip?
Well, I think PCs are extremely important in the overall ecosystem. Now, there's no question that there was, you know, a bit of excess, you know, sort of very higher demand over the last, you know, 18 months, 2 years, and now we're in a period of lower demand. But I still believe, you know, the PC experience, when you talk about working from home, when you talk about working on the road, when you talk about enterprises and everything that you have to do there, when you talk about gaming, you know, there's definitely a very, you know, very good overall demand, and we just have to work through, you know, sort of this, you know, next couple of quarters and ensure that, you know, the demand-supply picture gets back into balance.
At the Fortune Most Powerful Women Summit recently, you said running AMD is like running a new company every 2 years. Explain that.
It is something like that. But, you know, the way I think about it is, look, technology is such fast-paced, right? If you think about the technology trends, and if you think about the size of our company, when I first took over as CEO, we were a $5 billion company. You know, this year we'll be a $23.5 billion company. We have a lot more employees. We have a lot more product lines. And, you know, the world's a different place. Mm-hmm. So we love it. You know, we love the dynamic nature of the business, and we also believe that that's one of our core strengths, is we're able to really navigate through, you know, sort of a lot of different things.
AMD shares were on a tear for so long, and they have taken a hit with the rest of the market. Is that hard to watch? Does it change anything for you as you run the company?
Well, we certainly believe that, you know, the right thing to do is to focus on the long-term strategy. And the long-term strategy is, you know, product roadmaps, you know, deep customer relationships, continuing to innovate. And, you know, that's where we spend, you know, 99% of our time. And of course, you know, we all want to ensure that all of our stakeholders are happy with the progress. And so we're always, you know, working on those things.
And I know I've asked you this multiple times over the last several years, the state of the chip crisis. What phase are we moving into now?
Well, I think you said it earlier. I think we have gotten, you know, over the hump of, you know, sort of the chip shortage, as it was called. I know you've asked me that several times over the last couple
it's
of years.
It's been the question of the day
for
2 years now.
And I think what I've said each time is that the semiconductor industry knows how to do this. We know how to put on enough capacity to satisfy demand. We have seen, you know, a much better supply-demand balance now than certainly over the last couple of quarters. And I think we are, you know, for the most part, meeting supply meeting demand that's out there. Now, there are certain still pockets of shortages, and those will be worked through, you know, as well. So
what does the chip industry look like through a recession? How does the chip industry, in your view, weather this?
We have, certainly we're very familiar with these types of cycles. And what it means is, you know, we have periods of build phase, which is what the last 18, 24 months were. And then we have, you know, periods where you know, there's, you know, less capacity being brought on. And, you know, again, we know how to manage through these things. Perhaps the most important thing, though, is to focus on, you know, what are the secular growth drivers that are going to continue to be important. That's why data centers are so important. Energy efficiency becomes so important. Business transformation for enterprises are so important. And then, you know, things like, you know, gaming and, you know, are also, you know, secular growth drivers. So, you know, I'm very optimistic about the long term, and we're, you know, very well prepared to manage through the short term.
Is it a time of M&A? Is it a time of consolidation? Is AMD looking at opportunities out there?
Well, first of all, we're extremely excited with how well our recent M&A has done. So, you know, we closed the Xilinx acquisition in February. They've now been part of the, you know, the AMD family for the last, you know, 7-8 months. It's gone fantastically well. The business is fantastic, so above our acquisition case. We also acquired a company called Pensando, which is a specialist in, you know, networking technologies as well. And so, it, you know, M&A has been very good for us. But I would say, you know, running a very strong organic business is also, you know, sort of front and center in what we do.